Hello everyone, this is Just a Dad. Today I'm going to do a review on the Shark Cordless Detect Pro with Auto Empty System. This is a cordless stick vacuum, and when you put it on the base, it empties out whatever is in here, it empties out into the chamber down below. Now the Auto Empty Bin has this odor neutralizing technology. You're going to open up this bag and you're going to install it right here. Okay, so first line up the green arrows and then you're going to turn it. And we can do different levels of odor neutralizing technology. So whenever this thing sucks out the stuff of the vacuum cleaner, it's gonna put off a nice scent. Okay, so let's turn the vacuum cleaner on. We got a power button. We've got three different modes of operation. We've got auto mode, we've got low, which is eco mode, and we got max, which has maximum suction all the time. Now in auto mode or Detect Pro, you're going to have this bar that goes across. If your floor is clean, it's going to be blue. As it senses the floor gets dirty, like I got some dirt here on the floor, it's going to turn red. It's going to ramp up the suction and the roller speed to clean the floor better. Then as it gets cleaner, it's going to lower the suction. That's how it saves battery. Okay, I got a really big mess on the floor. I got a coffee, some dog hair, and some cereal. Now again, we're going to turn it on. It's in auto mode or Detect Pro, and that's gonna turn red as it senses the dirt and debris. A little hard to see, but it is red, and as it cleans it, it will turn back to blue. So as the floor gets clean, then it ramps down the suction and turns back to blue. There, it's blue. Now if I want, I can go to eco mode, which is going to be just low suction all the time. It won't use that auto mode, and there's maximum suction. Your battery won't last as long on that. Hit it again, now I'm in detect mode. Okay, so there's all the dirt and debris it picked up. Let's turn it off. Now let's go put it on the base. Now when I put it on this base, it's going to charge the cordless stick vacuum, and it's also going to suck everything out of this chamber. It's really neat. This is one of the main reasons I love these self-emptying bases. And down here in the base unit, it's going to kick on a separate vacuum cleaner that's going to suck everything out of the stick vacuum. And it's all automatic. You don't have to do anything. You're simply going to set it on the base. Oh, I love that part. So it's going to do that, it's going to shut off, and then it's going to charge it automatically. And this odor neutralizing technology, I can smell really fresh air. And now it's just sitting here waiting for you to use it the next time, and it will be charged, ready to go. Now this base unit, it holds quite a bit. When you're ready to empty this, you're just going to lift this handle straight up, and we're going to take this over and empty this into the garbage can. Okay, so here I've got the canister. It's got a release button here. Make sure it's over the trash can. Press the release button and everything comes out. Okay, I want to talk a little bit about the vacuum. We've got these modes: dirt detect, edge detect, floor detect, and light detect. We already talked about dirt detect. That's when it saw the dirt on the floor and it ramped up the power and the suction. Now we've got edge detect. So down here on the cleaning head, we've got these edge sensors right here. Once in a while, you'll have to wipe these off, but there's an edge sensor here. And also on this side, this is gonna sense when it's up against the wall. When it's up against the wall, it's gonna ramp up the suction because it's trying to bring in stuff that's next to the wall. Now we have floor detect. So as you go from hardwood floors to thick carpet, it's gonna adjust the roller speed automatically. It's gonna have a higher roller speed when you're on carpet as opposed to hardwood floors. Now the last, we got this light detect. Right here, there's a sensor. It's gonna detect how much light is in the room. And it's got these really bright LEDs that's gonna turn on if the room is dark. And these are only available when you're in auto detect mode or auto mode. This is how it helps save battery. Another feature I like is this little circle here. This is actually gonna turn red and blue according to how much dirt is on the floor. So if you're vacuuming and you're looking down at the floor, you don't have to look at the vacuum itself. You're gonna see that same sensor right here turned blue or red, depending on how much dirt. Okay, so let's take a look at the cleaning brush. We got this release button here. You're gonna press this release button, and you're simply gonna slide it out. The whole roller is attached to this, and I can get this all nice and clean. I can clean inside of here. Now when I'm ready, I can simply just put it back in, line up that gear, and snap it close. Let's take a look at the actual vacuum part. I can also disconnect it here. I can add attachments. It comes with two attachments that I can put on and do some, like, clean some stairs. There's also a crevice tool that's very easy. Okay, so we've got, this is the chamber. I can empty this chamber myself. If I take it over to a trash can, I press that button, everything's gonna come out. Now there is a filter in here. I gotta make sure this is open in order to take out this filter. I'm gonna squeeze both sides. Now this comes out, and here's where I have this filter that I can clean off once in a while. Then I'm simply gonna slide it in and close this. I also have a filter up here. I'm gonna turn this counterclockwise. Now that I can take this off, and here's a HEPA filter in here like this. Put it back, put this on. When you put this on, make sure the filter is snapped in all the way. Then this will fit on there, like this. Then I'm gonna rotate this outer edge here to lock that into place. Now it also has a removable battery, but when you've got it on the charging base, that's what's gonna charge it. But here's what the battery looks like. And here is where the charging on the base comes into these two prongs and goes in and charges the battery. Okay, so let's go clean some carpets and some hardwood floors. Okay, so I got a real torture test here. I got some cereal, coffee, dirt, dog hair, all kind of in this carpet. We're gonna watch and see how it does. So first we're gonna turn it on. I'm gonna do auto detect. So it's very lightweight. It's really ramping up the roller brush because it knows it's on carpet, and it's ramping up the suction also. It glides really easy over this thick carpet, but it's also doing a good job of cleaning it. Now it's back to the auto detect is blue, so it's not dirty anymore. And I like that it's not very loud either. And again, I'm just really amazed at how well it picks up. Now I'm gonna clean some hardwood floors, but I just wanna show you again the self-emptying base, how well it works. Okay, so I got a bunch of coffee grounds, some big chunks of cereal, dog hair. Now take notice, when it gets next to the edge, the sensor is gonna sense that and ramp up the suction. And let's see how, I'm gonna do this in auto detect mode. Okay, so it's turning red. Now let's go up next to the edge. So it ramps up the suction when you're against the edge. It does a really good job next to the edge. I just can't stress how lightweight this is, but yet very powerful. And just glides so easy. So I had a lot of stuff next to that edge. It did a really good job up next to the edge. It also cleaned the floor very well. Okay, so I've got some dog hair on this carpet. Let's watch the auto detect for the light. So we're gonna see the light come on bright. So it's sensing that dirt. I can really see where I need to go. It's really dark right here. And if this is another way that it helps save battery by not keeping that light on bright all the time. Okay, so the self-emptying base also has a silent mode. So say you want to dock this, but you don't want to disturb anybody. Press this button right here, and that little light's gonna come on. Now when you dock it, it's gonna charge it, but it won't empty out the chamber. This can be a little annoying if you're somebody's trying to sleep or something, and you dock it and it turns on that really powerful vacuum. So, and if you, whenever you turn it off, it's gonna kick on the suction, so be careful. So as soon as I disable that now, it will empty out the chamber. We also have a light here that's gonna let you know when it's time to empty out this. Okay, so let's talk about the base a little bit. We do have this onboard storage. This is where the crevice tool is. Again, we lift this off. This is full of debris. We can take this over and empty it out. We do have some filters for the base unit. Now, once in a while, you will have to clean these out. There's a filter here and here. And you can rinse these out and reuse these, but make sure these are nice and dry before you reinstall them. Now over here on this side, we do have a HEPA filter. So you're gonna open this latch up, pull down, and this snaps out. There's your HEPA filter. Now to put it back in, you're gonna put it in, make sure it snaps in, and then put this in. Up here at the top, and snap that in. Here's what the bottom of the base unit looks like. It looks like the output to the cordless vacuum is 26.3 volts, 800 milliamps. Input to the base unit is 60 hertz, 5.4 amps. Let's take a closer look at the odor neutralizing technology. Again, you're gonna take it out, line up the arrows here. It comes out. You're gonna take this off. You can replace this. It's like a little gel. You're gonna replace that once in a while. Then when you get a new one, you're gonna line up the arrows, twist it to the lock position, and then you're gonna line up the arrows again, and then turn it. Again, I've got different levels. I always go to the maximum. It's gonna put out the maximum scent. Now if we take, I've emptied this out, we can take a look inside here real quick. We can see sometimes we do get a little bit of hair up there. Sometimes it's nice to take this outside and just kind of blow it out. Okay, let's go over some quick measurements. So on its base, you know, you're looking at about 44 inches. Now it's gonna stick out from the wall about 11 inches. And the widest part is the vacuum itself. That's about 10 and a half inches. Now runtime is gonna vary depending on how dirty your carpet, but to get the maximum amount of runtime, you are gonna wanna use the auto detect mode. I have been able to clean several different rooms because it can ramp up the suction to help save battery. And using that auto detect really does work. But I can't stress enough how lightweight and powerful this is. This is probably the lightest weight and most powerful stick vacuum that I've used. Now I did buy this with my own money and I was not paid for this video. Now the emptying base, I'm finding this to be, you know, I wish this was, it's actually a little dirty. I love the unit, don't get me wrong, but I haven't done very much vacuuming. That filter's already getting pretty dirty. This thing seemed a little messy when I was opening it and closing it. In my next video, I'm gonna compare it to this one. This was their first self-emptying base stick vacuum. I really do love it, so I'm gonna be doing a side-by-side comparison with it. So this does retail for $450. They are gonna be putting it on sale. I will put links to it in the show description notes, so underneath the video, click on the See More, and you'll see some links that'll take you to Shark or to Amazon. I am a Shark and an Amazon affiliate. Underneath the video, if you could give it a thumbs up, that really does help out my YouTube channel. Also, check out my Just a Dad Videos Group Facebook page. I'll be doing my free giveaways on this. They'll be behind the scenes of how videos are made. I'm also releasing my brand new coffee. I branded my own coffee. We went down and did some taste testing. We're working on bag design right now. It's going to be a dark roast, Just a Dad Simple Sip Coffee. You can follow along on the coffee journey on my Just a Dad Videos Group page. I really do appreciate everybody's support. This would not be possible without everybody, so thank you very much. And again, if you could, please like and subscribe, and thanks for watching.